This is my biggest and grandest Lego mock yet, and I built it in only 4 days. Yep, 3 floors full of interior detail, custom minifigs, and all these moving parts, all in under 96 hours. Oh, and there's a giant dragon too. Let's take a closer look at both the fortress and fire drake to see who would win in a hypothetical battle. Originally, this mock was supposed to be sort of a steampunk windmill, but then I had the idea to put a minecart on it because minecarts are, you know, the best, and it kind of spiraled into this. The dragon was sort of an afterthought addition, and a fantastic one at that, but we'll get to that later. For now, cast your eyes to the facade of the fortification, the surface of the citadel, the peripheral of the palace, the exterior of the castle. I went for a fairly traditional color scheme with light gray walls and dark red roofs, accented with a black bridge and foundation. All this custom rock work, sculpted from a variety of different sized slopes, acts as a pretty solid base to the model. Upon these rocks grow several different types of foliage, all of which provide some much needed pops of color. A flowering vine, some random bushes and grass, and my favorite, these scraggly custom built trees on either side. This breathtaking bridge, brandished with these torches, leads to a pair of majestic wooden doors with a set of wrought iron inner gates. You got your standard brick pattern wall, which I actually had to steal pieces from this castle, which I never ended up making a video on, to build. That makes up the main edifice of the castle, topped with crenellations as well as these two towers. All in all, the exterior of this castle would stand a pretty good chance of defending itself against any potential dragon attacks. But what's even inside the castle that's so worth protecting? Let's start at the lowest floor and work our way up through these 3 levels, full of little details and scenes. Down in the depths of this colossal cavern lies a dwarven mine populated with, well, dwarves. They are hard at work excavating all sorts of precious metals, which they transport through the tunnels, which don't make a whole lot of sense, but you'll just have to imagine, using the minecart that inspired this entire project. All the tools and accommodations needed to live down here are provided for the dwarves, and they are even able to export their raw ores and import their food through this neat mechanical pulley system, which takes us up to our next floor, the forge! Let's start here with the gaping hole in the floor that we've entered through. It is achieved using this piece, the modified 12x24 plate with 6x6 square cutouts at 2 corners and 6x6 round cutout. No, really, that's the official name for it. It only ever appeared in 4 LEGO Dimensions sets, and it seems to have very limited uses. But I am super happy that it ended up becoming a core feature of the castle, along with this pulley, which we'll just remove for now to get a better look further back in the actual forge. Here, the master blacksmith, along with his assistant Wally, smelts all the minerals hoisted up from the dwarves over a blazing furnace until they are malleable enough to hammer into all the tools, weapons, and armor that the castle guard needs to fend off pesky dragons. Everything a blacksmith needs to prosper is here. A coal chest, anvil, water bucket, and a weapon rack, where finished products are stored until they are taken up the stairs to be used by the knights on duty. The third and final floor, where said knights tirelessly defend the castle from, isn't as big or detailed as others, but I tried to cram in as much as I could, including this cook making stew, a bunkhouse where knights can sleep, and a catapult, which can launch rocks for defense, or minifigs, if necessary. This chimney even bellows smoke up from the forge it's connected to on the floor below. Overall, this upper floor of the castle is still cool, and it really ties the whole model together, which I must reiterate is one of the best things I've built to date. But is it strong enough to withstand the might and ferocity of this brick-built dragon? Well, probably. I wanted to put as much range of motion as possible into this guy, but as a result, it isn't very sturdy, and will fall over pretty easily. But ignoring that factor, this dragon is awesome! His vibrantly colored scales were purposely made as striking as possible so it would stand out against the more drab castle, mostly for the thumbnail. We also had a lot of blue. I will admit, the head is more or less copied from a pictured official set, because I was terrible at building heads otherwise, but I did change the shape up a bit, and I tried to give it some more unique pieces, like this purple flame, which goes excellently with the color scheme. The neck is made up of 3 independently moving segments, which makes this thing even less sturdy, connecting the head to the main body of the dragon. From here, its brick-built wings stretch wide across, allowing the creature to soar gracefully through the sky. Their dark blue base, made possible by this agent's jet set, is beautifully detailed with these lines, claws, and even more moving joints. These alone took me hours to get right. Some may say that the body itself is kind of flat, but I tried to arch the back the best I could, which was difficult to do with the wings connected here. With the bright yellow belly below and the back spikes above, I think I'm more than made up for the flatness, and I even threw in this hinge midsection to provide even more movement. Finally, there's the questionably sturdy legs and the very long and spindly tail, complete with a thagomizer. Apparently that's what this thing is called. The mixel joints that make up the tail are surprisingly the most sturdy thing about the dragon, who, again, on the whole, even though he looks really cool, probably couldn't stand up against the castle, or just stand up in general. But let's find out who would win once and for all. I've been hyping it up this whole video, and now, finally get to see the legendary battle between the castle and the dragon.
I'm sorry, dragon, not to come to this. I got a replacement head for you.
And that concludes this mock showcase. I hope you enjoyed all I was able to pack into this one during those 4 days of building. Comment below with your favorite part of either the castle or dragon. And if you want more LEGO stuff like this, be sure to hoist up that subscribe button from the mines and smack it with the hammer. Until next time, have a good night.